Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to a fun project. Today I'm going to create a treat box and I will be using the new die set by Tonic Studios. This is a monthly die kit. It is not a subscription kit. You get to see the products and if you like them, you can order them. I also have a coupon code for them, so check down below in the description area to get it in a better price. In the Designer's Choice die kit this month there are more than 20 dies and I'm going to talk a little bit on each and every one of them since they look quite complicated as they are on the right. Now, you need to create a little treat box, you need a base and they give you three options. So you can have a pentagon, a square and a little triangle as your base. Now you need a wall for your treat box and this square fits on every one of those bases. So all you need to do is to cut it out for the pentagon 5 times, for the square 4 times and for the triangle obviously 3 times. I will be creating the square one for today as an example, but it is the exact same process for everything. So this is the wall. Now at the top you need a roof. For the roof you will use this die here. And again, it fits on each and every one of those bases. So depending on the box that you are going to create, you will need this 5 times for the pentagon, 4 times for the square, and 3 times for the triangle. Now here's a finished project and you can see at the top of the roof, you will need one more piece, which is different depending on the base that you are starting with. And that's where you use the smaller version of each shape. And then finally you get a bunch of decorative dies that you can mix and match on the basic shapes. So for example, this gives you a lovely lace looking design that you can fit on the roof if you like to cut out windows and lovely details. If you want to cut out a separate piece of cardstock, then you can use this die, which is a solid one, or you can mix and match it with the decorative ones. And the exact same idea goes for the square, which is the wall. So here you get a little heart. This is a treat box that it is supposed to be for Valentine's Day, so they give you little hearts and everything to embellish it. But of course, if you omit those, you can use a treat box for pretty much any occasion. And always remember that the basic shapes, the hearts, the little flowers that they give you can be used for other projects as well. You don't really need to use them on treat boxes. They can easily be used to create cards. Now finally you get three little dies that cut out flowers, can be used in pretty much any project, love that they are tiny. You get a little heart tag with a lovely lace design all around. Now there is a tiny triangle die that cuts out a little tab for the top of your handle and here is an example where I used it. And finally there are more dies, teeny tiny ones, this one embosses a little flower and this one cuts out a lovely heart design. So let's make a treat box and you can see easier how you can put all these dies together. For creating my box I will be combining two different colors of cardstock. This is a lovely embossed one and it is called Salmon Harlequin and the other one is a matte silver. I will be using those two different colors for the sides and the roof and I hope this is going to be helpful as I put the box together so you can see exactly what I'm doing. I'm going for the square box, so I will be using the square to cut out the base for my box. I will be using the other square with the tabs to cut out 4 times this shape. This tiny one is the top of the roof, I will cut it out from silver. This is the roof and I need 4 of those out of silver again. I did all the die cutting, so I have 4 walls, 4 roofs, I have the base with a large square and the top of the roof with a small square. As you run your die to cut out the roof pieces, you will see that it creates a little slit. This is helpful to close the box later on. Now this is the stage where you need to decide which decorative elements you are going to use on your pieces. I'm going really simply here today as I lack clean and simple on my boxes. I will be using the heart die to cut out a window on one of the sides of my box. I'm also going to use this tab die at the top of my roof to cut out a little tab where I can thread the string later on. And I will use the flower dies to cut out a bunch of flowers in case I want to use them later on to decorate my box. And now after running everything through my die cutting machine, I have my little window there, I have the tab at the top of my roof, and now it is time to add some acetate at the back of this piece so that anything that I have inside my treat box doesn't fall out. First I'm going to score the tabs, making sure that they are nicely scored there, and I'm using my bone folder for that. And then I'm going to apply some glue and stick a piece of acetate there. And I'm going to let this piece dry as I'm working on the rest of the pieces. Now I do have to do the scoring. First I'm folding everything with my fingers, and there is a scoring line that was made by the die as I ran them through my die cutting machine. So I like to work assembly line, I'm scoring everything with my fingers and then go back again to reinforce the scoring lines with my bone folder. Doing that with a bone folder really makes a difference. It's going to help your treat boxes to look more professional and perfectly looking at the end. Now I have some thin double-sided tape and I'm going to apply it on all the tabs, on all the pieces. Of course you can use your white glue to put your box together, depends on what you find easier. When you use your white glue, you will be able to slide those pieces together easier until they are perfectly placed, but then you will have to hold it with your fingers until the glue dries. So the type of adhesive is a complete personal preference, I believe. And now finally it's time to put this together. I'm using the silver side on the outside of the box, but that really depends on what you like to do. And I'm going to stick all around the base the pink pieces. I'm going to put on some music so you can see how I put the box together. It is really easy, as you can see, and I'll catch you up once this is ready. I like to go inside those seams and press them with my bone folder just to make sure that everything is nicely stuck together. And my base is ready. I will go ahead and make the roof now. Now my little treat box is ready. It's looking super adorable. I'm going to thread a string, white string, through the tab at the top. I'm going to tie a little knot there, and I'm also threading that tag that I cut out using the dies that gives you a little heart, and at the back you can write to and from if you like. Now I decided to use two of the flowers, and I'm going to stick a smaller one inside a larger one with a foam square in between, so this gives some dimension and fluffiness to my flower, and I'm going to stick that with glue next to the little window heart. To add some extra sparkle, I'm going to add a little gem at the center of this flower. And I created the middle size, but you can see that it fits lots and lots of things here. So here I'm adding some chocolate. You can see it fits way more than three. And it could hold other little gifts rather than just chocolate. For example, you can fit earrings or a chain necklace. So many little things that would fit beautifully inside. Remember that you can add tissue paper inside to make sure that your treats don't move around. And I want to show you how easy it is to put the roof back on. those tabs just fall in place inside those slits with no problem at all. And if you want to secure it and make sure that it's not going to open, then you can just fold those tabs towards the bottom to lock the roof in place. Here are some close-up photos on today's project, and remember, this is a treat box that you can use all year round, not just for Valentine's Day. Down below in the description area, you will find links to the die kit that I used, along with a coupon code to get it in a better price. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment, like and subscribe if you haven't done so already, and I'll see you all next time. Have a lovely weekend!